Hello, it's Stuart Fenster, I'm the couples expert. Here's another edition of 3 Minutes with Stuart. Infidelity is one of the most difficult things for any relationship to deal with. And one of the questions that people often ask is, what does it take to overcome infidelity in our marriage? The first question you have to ask yourself before you even start that process is, are you sure you're prepared to do the work? What that means is you have to be willing to dig down incredibly deep within your, almost like it's within your soul, because there is no other pain that's more excruciating in a marriage. Your partner has violated a basic vow, a basic commitment to the two of you. If you're prepared to really deal with the issues, if you want to truly allow your two of you to maintain this relationship and to create something different than what you had, that's going to be incredibly painful. So often, one of the problems that I run into when I have a couple in my office that say, yes, we want to work on this. Yes, we know that we've had this violation. Yes, we want to stay together. I have to ask this question. Are you sure you know what you're taking on? Because so often the problem is people come into this thinking all it's going to take is talking about the affair and that'll be it. That's not the case. And so often, what I find is the partner that says, I want to do this, hasn't really committed to the process. Because that process requires you to make it acceptable that the behavior occurred. And not only that, you have to be willing to grieve for what you once thought you had. No relationship truly comes back from infidelity. The only thing that you can do is heal from it, recover from it, learn from it, and then bury your marriage. And what that means is taking all your hopes, all your dreams, and saying goodbye to them. Because unless you create something different from what you once had, you have a relationship that is susceptible to an affair. Do we want that? Are we truly going to forgive, and are we truly going to trust again if we think just around the corner it may happen again? If you have the same marriage that you once had, that's exactly what will come up over and over and over again until you're ready to just explode. You see, you have to get authentic about the needs, which means you have to be willing. If you're the one that is dealing with the affair, not the person that had the affair, you have to be willing to say to yourself, I have to take some of the responsibility. That doesn't mean it's your fault. That doesn't mean it's you're the one that caused it. What it means is that you have to be willing to hear what your partner needed from you that you didn't give. You have to be willing, and your partner has to be willing to really recognize what they did. That what they did was really violate in an incredibly deep way someone that they said they loved. That's not a loving act. I hear people say all the time, I had this affair, but I love my wife. I think it's a bunch of crap. I don't think you loved your wife. Because no one hurts someone they love in this way. I think you didn't really understand what love is about. I think there were needs that you had buried inside of you. And unless the two of you begin to talk about those needs, unless your partner can say to you, this is why I had the affair, and I hurt you as a result, there's no recovery. A recovery of an affair is two people digging down deep, having a really clear understanding of who they are, what their attachment needs are, and together, saying goodbye to what you had and starting over, having a relationship that meets both of your needs in a most deep way, deeper than you've ever had, and what you may be able to create if you can be mature and really dig down deep and take responsibility where it needs to be taken, something that people only dream about. A new relationship, a relationship that's filled with love, a bond that would last the rest of your life, and have both of you knowing that this one person in the world, of everybody else in this world, can meet your need in a truly authentic way, and there's no one that will ever meet that need in the same way and would love you more. Take care and stay connected. Bye-bye.